欢迎啊！欢迎大家收听华语电台 CCL 文化潮流菲律宾，我是 Janet 啊。今日咧，我请到一位朋友上嚟咧，女士们会好高兴嘅。我自己本身就非常之期待佢今日嘅出现啦，因为咧，我今日请回呢位朋友咧，佢系一位化妆师嚟嘅，仲要系一位好出名嘅化妆师。除咗系一位化妆师咧，佢亦都系有开好多fashion show 嘅，因为呢个时装界嘅一位达人啊，真系。咁所以咧，我今日咧知道佢上嚟之后咧，我自己咧除咗好热切期待同佢倾关于菲律宾嘅事咧，我都非常之期待可以同佢讲一讲咧，佢呢一个佢呢个时装界同埋呢个化妆界嘅行业嘅。Thank you for listening to the Canadian Chinese Radio. This is the CCL Culture Trends of the Philippines. This is Janet again, and once you hear my voice, you will know that it is the Filipino program. And today, I am especially happy because the guest who is here today, it's a makeup artist, and she. Well, once I know that she is coming today, I am so happy. I have lots of questions for her. As a woman, I really do have lots of questions to her, trust me. But of course, she is here to talk about the Philippines. But since she has such a great background, I can't wait to talk to her about herself first. So let's welcome Faye. Hi, Faye.
Hi, Janet.
Hi. Thank you so much for coming.
Oh, yes. Thank you so much, too. First of all, I'd like to thank you for inviting me over to the Canadian Chinese Radio. And it is indeed a great pleasure to be with you today.
Thank you. I was so happy when I know that Owen McMart is coming. first of all, why don't you introduce yourself to the audience first?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Hi, I'm Faye Olier Gatus. I'm, well, a Filipino-Canadian. My family migrated to Canada more than 6 years ago. And prior to that, I was a career executive officer in the Philippine government financial institution. Well, now I'm a freelance international makeup artist, a voice coach, a certified artist developer, an event organizer, and a manager of a fashion store in the Richmond Hill area. I used to be a radio host of Pinoy Link. Mm-hmm. It is a program reaching out to the Filipino community.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So many titles.
I know. It's like all rolled into one, right?
That's actually good. 同大家介紹一下先，阿飛啦，咁佢就係移民咗嚟加拿大咧六年度。咁佢以前喺菲律賓咧，佢係做依個嘅 financial 嘅部門嘅。咁亦都喺菲律賓咧係擁有一間時裝店嘅。咁嚟到加拿大啦，佢做啲咩咧？佢就而家做一個 freelance 嘅makeup artist， 即係化妝師啦。咁同埋佢以前咧，佢都喺一個菲律賓嘅電台咧做DJ 嘅。咁啊，即係聽佢把聲就知啦，咁好聽，唔好嘥咗佢啊嘛。咁佢嚟到呢一個加拿大咧，仍然都係對呢一個嘅化妝啊，同埋時裝咧，非常之有呢一個嘅興趣同埋呢個熱誠嘅。咁所以咧，佢仍然都係從事緊呢兩個嘅行業嘅。Faye, yes, so happy because you have so many titles and all the titles are related to all I love.
Like fashion and entertainment.
Oh yes. And entertainment. Oh yes, I have to tell the audience first. 頭先我講漏咗一樣嘢，就係其實佢除咗係呢一個嘅化妝師啊，呢個時裝界嘅consultant 之外咧，佢唱歌都好犀利嘅。我哋好多嘢同佢傾啊咁樣。So about first of all, about your fashion sense, mm-hmm. and your makeup, like being a makeup artist.
Yeah.
I'm always curious. what makes you, first of all, what makes you to become a makeup artist and also I don't think I need to ask you why you are so into fashion because I'm a woman too. But then yeah, do tell us about that.
Yeah, well, it's a long story, but I'll try to make it short. When I migrated to Canada, as I mentioned prior to that, I was a career government executive officer, right? So mm-hmm. it's like the other part of my brain is on the you know, leaning on that side. But then when I moved to Canada, I started thinking, what is it that I really, really want? And then she's actually a Chinese-Jamaican mentor, and she asked me, what is your passion? What do you really want to do? So I started like contemplating whether, you know, I would do a little studying on a, you know, on the career side, more on the, you know, on the line that I used to, you know, be doing in the Philippines. So, but then I tried to explore the other part of my brain. So I said, okay, I think I'd like to go on the art side this time. So I studied, I went into trainings, and the more I went into trainings, the more I get interested in it. So I went to the US, I started, training on a makeup thing, and then that started it all. I started doing fashion shows already. I got a clientele of, you know, fashion models. I started doing some shows in New York, and it's like, this is fun. You know, it's like living in an entirely different world, right, than I used to do when I was in the Philippines. And I find it really, really fun and entertaining and exciting.
原来呢阿菲呢佢係好特别嘅。因为佢喺菲律宾呢佢係做政府嘅部门啦。咁当佢移民到嚟加拿大呢佢就諗啦，同埋佢当其实有一个人生嘅导师咁样啦。咁佢就同佢傾偈，佢就话其实你人生想要啲乜嘢呢咁。咁当其实佢就諗啲其实我都真係想试其他嘢。咁佢就諗呢关于 art 嘅一啲嘢啦，咁于是乎咧，佢就毅然咧就去到New York 啦，去到美国咧，就去学呢一个嘅化妆，咁啊接受咗好多 training 啊嘅嘢之后，咁突然间咁样就开埋时装 show 添啊，佢直情话真系好大嘅转捩点，但系就好快亦都好顺利咁成功咗，就飞It's really a big twist, I think.
Yeah.
Like from like you were in a government, like you work for the government, when you were in the Philippines. But of course, you actually own a fashion boutique at the Philippines.
Yes, I do have.
But then once you move to Canada, all of a sudden you just want to learn like makeup.
Yeah. Well.
Then you went to U.S.
Yes. And then. I used to sing in the Philippines too. I was a member of a choir,
mm-hmm.
So we sang for some, you know, foreign dignitaries before.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided to like do voice coaching too. So right now it's like music and fashion for me.
Oh, so right now you are also doing the voice coaching, like you actually
teach. It's actually more on stage performance.
Oh, okay.
How they should, you know. Act on stage, how they should project themselves when they're singing. It's more on refining the artist.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. 原来呢阿菲佢话呢佢其实喺呢个嘅菲律宾度呢佢係 choir 嚟嘅。咁嚟到加拿大呢佢都继续呢譬如教人哋点样唱歌啊，但主要嚟讲呢都係教人哋呢喺舞台上面呢有啲乜嘢嘅技巧呢係需要知道等等嘅事项嘅。So Faye, back to, your profession. Fashion and makeup artist.
Mm-hmm.
So you have just told us how like and what makes you want to be a makeup artist, but why you would choose to go to the States to learn that?
Well, no, actually, it's more like I went into training here in Canada, but of course. You want to learn more about other cultures.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I mean, in the fashion sense. Because fashion-wise, we're also good, but we're more, you know, influenced by the British when we dress up, right? Mm-hmm. Especially in fall, you can see that. Fall time, winter time, it's more British,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
I just want to see and explore how it is on the other side,
mm-hmm.
like in the U.S., because in the U.S., it's like a mix of everything, you know? It's like, it's pop art is U.S.
Mm-hmm.
It's really like, it's a mix of all the different fashion trends, yeah, throughout the years.
Mm-hmm.
And it makes it I can say it makes it more colorful.
Mm-hmm.
So here we are good. I mean, Toronto is really very good in fashion. But of course, it does not stop there, right?
Mm-hmm.
You want to explore further.
Mm-hmm.
If possible, go to other different countries,
mm-hmm,
and come up with a nice combination, you know, that represents all this other culture.
阿菲咧，佢就话诶，点解佢当初会选择去到美国度诶学呢一个嘅化妆咧？或者系 fashion 啦，即系两样都有关系嘅。咁佢就话，因为佢好想 explore 多啲嘢。美国系好多嘢都系即系真系好尖端啦。咁即系所有嘢都系同埋咩都有嘅。咁佢就好想将佢自己學識嘅嘢或者已經知道嘅嘢再去提升多啲，咁所以佢就選擇咗去到美國咧，再做多啲training 同埋進修。咁佢已經成功咗啦，因為其實佢係一個非常之出名嘅 makeup artist 嚟嘅，咁啲雜誌都會訪問佢嘅。咁啊同埋佢都講過佢喺呢個嘅美國咧都有埋呢個 fashion show 噶啦。咁啊，所以我哋問多啲佢關於 fashion show 同埋 makeup artist 嘅事啦。It's good, and you went to the States, and turned out you are successful because, mm-hmm, you are a very good makeup artist, and also you have your fashion show
okay,
in the
you.
States too. So, what? How did it start? The fashion show in the States.
Well, it all started with me doing charity works, because when I was still in the Philippines, part of my income, I give it to an orphanage.
Mm.
And I specifically asked them to, you know, place it on the educational fund of these less privileged children. So whenever I do fashion shows, there will always be the charity side of it. And I was in New York one time, you know, just watching the fashion trends, watching people, observing how they dress. You know, I was on Fifth Avenue and I met an old friend, and we started talking about fashion shows, because as a woman, of course, she's also interested. Like, wow, what are you doing now? He said, so, like, yeah, I'm into makeup, I'm into fashion shows, I'm into entertainment. And she was just so happy to hear about it. And I started telling her about my dreams, you know, of helping these kids, which I used to do in the Philippines. I used to do feeding programs. And then she said, okay, maybe we can just do that here too. So she started gathering people, artists in New York, and everything just fell into the right place. So we've met some fashion designers who are interested to work with us, some famous international chefs, and that was it. It was like a real blessing coming from heaven, you know. So at least in our own way, we were able to help these kids, right? So,
mm-hmm. Yeah. And that show was for charity as well?
Yes, mm-hmm. It's for charity.
咁我問到阿菲點解會喺呢一個嘅New York 度咁即係學下化妝，學下關於呢一方面嘅嘢，或者fashion 呢方面嘢，會突然間開到 fashion show 咁犀利嘅咧？咁原來佢話佢喺New York 咧喺 Fifth Avenue 度撞到個朋友，咁啊傾開偈啦，咁大家女人就梗係啊傾啊 fashion show 又依樣又嗰樣，咁傾傾下突然間就話其實我就好中意睇 fashion show 嘅，咁佢個朋友就話其實點解我哋唔喺呢度做一個 fashion show 咧，一個自己嘅 fashion show 咧？咁就系一句说话，咁就佢开始啦，联络下啲朋友啊，咁样，咁佢都系好自然咁样联络晒啲朋友，咁就做到呢件事啦。咁当时呢个 fashion show 咧都系 for 呢个筹款嘅 for charity 嘅。咁因为咧阿菲其实一个非常之有爱心嘅朋友嚟嘅，佢就算佢喺美国度做紧 makeup artist 嘅时候咧，佢自己部分嘅 income 咧都系咧捐去俾呢一个嘅慈善机构。咁佢主要就系捐俾咧一啲孤儿啊嗰、那个嘅慈善机构嘅。咁所以佢本身系一个好有爱心嘅人。咁当谂到 fashion show 嘅时候咧，佢都系想为慈善而做呢一件事嘅。So that's very meaningful.
yes, it is.
yeah, it is definitely meaningful.
Yeah.
And I know that that after the fashion show in the States, you also held fashion shows in Canada for charity reason too.
Yeah. Even prior to that, I've been doing like mini concerts for some artists,
mm-hmm,
and fashion shows here and there. Like I did one here at a Sheraton too.
Mm-hmm.
They're all for charity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I know that you have a special theme for your fashion show. Mm-hmm. Which is you combine music
yeah,
and fashion.
That's exactly me, you know? I mean, that's exactly the artistic side of me.
Mm-hmm.
That's why all my fashion shows, I usually, especially here in Toronto, I use music and fashion. One, two, three.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah. You mean like you were actually sing in the fashion show yourself?
I have. Most of them are my talents, the mm-hmm. ones that I help. You know, these are like... you know, the new singers trying to make their own names.
Mm-hmm.
So, well, I try to feature them in between the fashion show.
Mm-hmm.
So they sing in between those runway stints.
咁啊，我就同阿飞讲，咁其实佢我知道佢嘅 fashion show 系有特别嘅主题嘅，佢就系将音乐同埋 fashion 咧 combine 埋一齐嘅。咁佢就唔系话真系会佢自己去唱嘅，佢都会间中即系客串下咁啦。但系其实佢好多时就会俾佢训练出嚟嘅即系对演艺表演啊有天分嘅朋友咧，喺 fashion show 中间间唱嘅时候咧，就俾佢哋表演。或者有些新的歌手啊，他会在那里给他们机会去到表演的。一个对音乐非常有热诚的人呢，真的对音乐可以跟很多人都可以 combine 在一起的，而跟 fashion show combine 在一起，我觉得是一个非常完美的配合。And I know that you actually took the course about makeup in the States, and then you had your fashion show.
Mm-hmm.
And then here you also have your fashion show. But like, what do you do in the fashion show? Like, are you in charge of the makeup and fashion and music, all of these?
Actually, I almost do everything, right? But I have a few volunteers too who work with me. But the concept. I'm actually the event organizer, right? So, down from the concept down to the, you know, the dresses that they wear, or the what do you call it? The whole program.
Mm-hmm.
I actually oversee those things.
Mm-hmm.
I coordinate with some stores if they want to display their clothes during the fashion show. And one time, I think I worked with. I don't know if you've read about it, the Scarves of Hope. It's yep. actually a non-profit group which sells scarves to help the Indian children too who are homeless.
Mm-hmm.
So I worked with them one time and they had a chance to display their very nice scarves. Mm-hmm. And we were able to like, you know, earn a little from it and send the money to India.
Mm-hmm.
So it's more of talking to different organizations and asking them whether they want to be featured.
Mm-hmm.
Some fashion designers who want to be featured. So we display their clothes.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a win-win arrangement, you know. We help them and they help us too to at least earn something for our charity projects.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you do the makeup for the models as well?
Oh, yeah. But if the models are, I mean, if it requires 24 models, I would need to ask another volunteer makeup artist to help me out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, in that sense.
Wow, that's
yeah.
basically really everything.
Yeah, because you're like running from here to there, right? So uh-huh. we cannot do everything. So I invite some artists to help me out in that area.
問到阿飛，咁其實佢因為佢時裝界達人。化妝又是一位化妝師，咁對一個 run 一個 fashion show， 其實佢係 in charge 啲乜嘢咧？係咪真係由化妝啊、揀衫啊，全部都係佢咧？咁佢都話其實佢都幾乎做曬所有嘢噶啦，由揀咩嘢衫，或者俾啲 model 著啦。咁化妝咧，除非佢話好多好多個 model 啦，如果唔係佢都會做嘅。如果好多 model 咁，咪請另外一個 volunteer 同佢一齊去做幫手化妝。 咁啊，揀衫又係，咁可能有啲時裝店可能將啲衫想 display 嘅，咁又或者對上一次佢做過一個咧好有意義嘅，就係、是同一間又係專做 scarf 嘅，即係絲巾嘅一間鋪頭，咁但係其實佢都係做慈善作用嘅，佢都係想將啲賺到嘅錢咧就去捐去俾印度嘅，咁所以佢又同佢合作啦，咁就做一個 fashion show 咧就會啲 model 就會披住啲絲巾啊咁樣行出嚟做 modeling， 咁所有嘢成件事都係佢幾乎係去做曬噶啦，咁啊包括埋安排啲人唱歌，或者佢自己都可能會唱埋一份啦，咁非常之厲害嘅一位女士啊，I do look up to you, like wow, you do everything from makeup, like pick the clothes, and you are actually doing this for charity.
Yeah, it's really, really a little hard, you know, when you do it, because as I always say, for a 3-hour fashion show, it takes 3 to 4 months to prepare for it.
That's my next question.
Yeah,
so
it's really hard.
3 to 4 months
yeah.
to prepare a fashion show.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, from like choosing the models.
How many
models usually?
Usually it's like 6 males, 6 females.
6 males, 6 females.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
But then for this new project, I even have kids.
Wow.
So it's taking me a while.
That's probably longer
it's
then.
It's so hard to coordinate. Yeah, that's true.
Wow.
It's gonna take a bit longer than the usual.
Oh.
And it's multicultural too.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I'd like to emphasize that point because it's not only Filipino models.
Mm-hmm.
We are in a multicultural community, right? So I try to mix the models,
mm-hmm.
like some Filipinos, some Chinese, some really like Caucasians.
Mm-hmm.
So it looks good on stage, you know, on the runway, because it's so colorful.
Definitely. 我都正想問阿飛個問題就係、是。籌辦一個嘅 fashion show 要幾耐時間，佢就自動答咗我啦。佢話真係好多嘢做嘅。咁其實講緊一個 fashion show 咧，係3至4個鐘頭，佢要用3至4個月去籌備嘅。啊，你話幾多嘢做啊？同埋佢自己一個做曬咁滯喎。咁同埋佢我就問佢通常有幾多個 model， 佢話通常都有6男6女，但係嚟緊一個 fashion show 咧，佢就想加插埋小朋友。咁所以你諗下，仲要加插埋小朋友，成件事個難度仲要再高好多倍噶啦咁。啊，不過佢就好想同大家講，其實呢個 fashion show 唔係淨係 for 菲律賓嘅，佢個 model 咧其實係每一即係多國嘅多個民族都有嘅，即係佢話中國人又有菲律賓人又有白人都有，所以其實佢係想盡量做到嗰種好多民族多元化嗰種嘅感覺。咁同埋佢都話喺個 stage 度望落去咧係靚好多，同埋開心好多嘅。Face it's really special and are you going to have a fashion show like in the near future?
Yeah, I'm planning to do one within the year. I haven't really established the date yet because, as I said, this time I have kids. So sometime before the end of the year, but hopefully by fall, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or before fall, not winter because it's too cold.
Mm, that's true.
Yeah, so, I'm still organizing it, coordinating with, you know, these models and some kids. And well, it's still on the planning stage though, but I think it's going to be a very exciting one because this time it's not just the grown-ups.
Mm-hmm.
We have the kids helping their fellow kids, you know? So
yes.
It's more interesting.
Let us know when you have the show.
Oh,
thank you. 我就問到阿飛佢幾時會有第二，即係將來不久將來會唔會有一個fashion show 咧？咁佢就去籌備緊，希望秋天之前可以出到呢一個 fashion show 啦。因為今次牽涉埋細路仔咁，所以要多少時間去籌備。咁亦都唔想去到冬天去驚太凍。咁我哋真係好期待啦。咁希望咧，阿飛咧佢一知道佢有呢個 fashion show 嘅日子咧，就話俾我哋聽。咁我哋呢特登请阿飞上嚟，咁唔会淨係讲时装嘅，咁亦都唔会淨係讲佢化妆同埋 fashion show， 我哋当然呢要同佢讲讲关于菲律宾嘅嘢。咁我哋而家休息一阵先，广告返嚟之后呢，我哋同呢位咁出色嘅化妆师同埋时装界嘅大人呢再傾一傾呢关于菲律宾嘅一啲东西啊。 Let's take a break now. After that, Faye will still be here and she will talk with us more about the Philippines. So stay with us. 欢迎翻嚟 CCL 文化潮流菲律宾。我头先咧就同一位时装界达人啦，同埋呢个化妆师咧倾紧偈啦。咁跟住落嚟咧，阿菲咧佢就会同我哋咧倾一倾啦。呢个嘅菲律宾咧有一个地方咧好特别嘅，咁佢想同我哋介绍一下。Faye,
yes.
I know that you actually have a place to introduce to the audience, and that place is quite special. I searched a little bit about that too. This place is called Vegan.
Yes, it's located in the northern part of the Philippines. I have a Filipino-Spanish bloodline, and I was born in Manila, but my ancestors lived in that part of the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
So that place is dominated by, I mean, it was dominated by the Spaniards during the Spanish colonial era. So it was like, based on history, of course, we always hear about the Philippines being influenced by the Spaniards, and we were like colonized for more than 300 years. So yeah, that part of the country, most of them have the Spanish bloodline. So Vegan actually is the capital of Ilocosur. It's a trading post.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and it was actually established during the 16th century and was proclaimed as a World Heritage Site by the United Nations in 1999. And it was able to best preserve the example of a planned Spanish colonial town in Asia. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Faye 咧今日想同我哋介绍嘅地方咧，个名字就叫做 Vegan。咁点解咁特别咧？首先呢个 Vegan 咧就喺比较北边嘅菲律宾嘅北边嘅。咁原来咧呢个地方咧系最能够而家现时嚟讲最能够保存到这个嘅西班牙喺侵占呢个嘅菲律宾嘅时候咧，好多好多个 building 啊，同埋嗰种嘅环境啊，所有嘢都保存得好好嘅。咁呢个系个细摊嚟嘅，但系咧呢一个地方咧就系好早期咧就系俾呢一个嘅西班牙人咧侵占咗。咁所以咧佢真系好多个 building 咧都系好有西班牙嗰个嘅特色。咁佢话大家都知道啦，因为菲律宾喺即系俾呢一个西班牙咧统治咗真系超过300年噶啦，咁所以好多嘢都俾佢影响咗。咁而佢对呢个地方亦都特别有情意结嘅。咁呢个地方首先讲咧就系16世纪已经开始有呢个地方啦。而呢个地方当其时咧系一个非常之非常之方便嘅地方，就所以就成为咗个我哋叫 trading post， 即系咧俾各方面咧去到交易嘅一个地方，去进行好多好多唔同嘅贸易嘅一个地方。Yes, Faye. So this place, as you said, it was a trading post, and
yes.
Because it was dominated by the Spanish, in the much earlier stage, it still preserved like a lot of the buildings, still Spanish style.
Yeah,
a lot of things.
Yeah, what's very interesting is that the town was able to preserve, you know, the buildings, mm-hmm. the streets. It's like turning back the hands of time when you're there. It's like a movie, you know? It's like you lived in that century.
Okay.
It's actually a unique fusion of Asian building designs with European architecture. It's so unique. It's Chinese-European setting. So they have all those, you know, the European buildings designed like the olden period, 16th century up to the 19th century up to the 20th century, right? But it's really very exceptional because you can still see the cobblestones, the brick walls, you know, the streets are still the same. And they even have those, the horse-driven calash, you know, the carriages were in the the nobility, only the nobility can ride on those carriages that time. They still have it there.
你去到個地方就覺得好似翻咗好好耐好耐世紀，好似真係時光倒流咁，好似一套電影咁。而家你好似身處一個電影嘅拍攝場地或者嗰個嘅佈景啊。佢話真係成個 building 又係好歐綠色啊，但係又有中國，因為即係好嘅中國好菲律賓嗰種元素，咁即係 combine 埋咗菲律賓，就再加呢一個嘅西班牙。的元素入邊，所以成件事望落去咧，真係好特別，好特別。咁佢話你仲會見到啲石，用嗰啲石仔啊，石仔路啊，嗰啲嗰啲道路咧，係仲係用緊啲石仔鋪啦，啲牆仍然都係 keep 到好，即係當其時咁嘅樣貌啦。仲係最特別嘅地方就係仲有馬車嘅，當其時馬車淨係可以俾啲貴族用嘅啫嘛。咁啊，所以佢就話成件事翻到去咧係好特別，真係好似翻咗去16世紀嘅時候咁。So it's very special. I can imagine from your face actually when you when you recall that like so exceptional. It's like going back in time. It's your face actually tells a lot.
I really love that place.
And as you said, it's like going back to the 16th century when you go back.
That's true.
Did you go back to vegan very often?
Well, of course, now that I am in Canada, I can't really like go back there very often and visit the place. But when I was still in the Philippines, it has been like a practice of the family to, especially during summertime, the whole family goes to the province. And we stay there, we go to the town plaza, you know, we eat as a family. But what makes it more important is that you can feel your past, you know. I'm saying it's like you can feel your bloodline when you are there, because it feels so special. You are there to respect your ancestors. It's more like that feeling, you know, when you're there. So we always go there like almost every year.
Almost every year.
Yeah.
菲咧，佢就話佢而家係多倫多就真係冇得話成日翻去啦，但係佢以前喺菲律賓居住嘅時候咧，幾乎每一年咧都會去到 vegan 咧度一次嘅，尤其是喺通常都係喺夏天嘅時候。佢就話呢個其實係好似係佢屋企嘅一個傳統咁，每一年都會翻去呢個地方，因為呢一度係最能夠代表咧以前喺呢個嘅西班牙統治緊菲律賓嘅時代。仲好保存到嗰種成件事嘅氣氛同埋感覺，咁所以咧佢就好，佢哋成家咧就一定會帶啲細路仔咧去佢叫 feel their past， 即係去到落揾翻佢哋以前過去，去揾翻佢哋祖先嘅一啲嘅足跡。咁佢哋覺得呢一個舉動咧，就係尊重祖先嘅一個舉動嚟嘅。咁我覺得成件事好感性嘅，我尤其是由佢講出嚟，我覺得好感性嘅一件事。咁我哋不如問問阿菲咧，每一次翻到去，每年都翻去一次啦。以前細細個嘅時候都，咁有啲咩地方佢係特別中意嘅咧？菲，so you mentioned you have gone back to vegan like once a year almost when you were in the Philippines. In there, what?Any attractions or any place that you think that you like the most or that you miss the most?
Well, the whole town itself. I mean, when you think back, the whole town itself makes me miss the Philippines. You know, it's because all corners of the town was well preserved, right? So.You miss being there, walking around. You miss eating the food of vegan. You miss being with your fellow Ilocanos. You know, for me, it's the importance of looking back, you know, treasuring the place where you came from. I just don't love vegan because of its grandeur. I'm very proud of vegan because it is where I came from.
Okay.
And that is where my roots are.
Mm-hmm. So whenever you went back, you simply just walk around?
We walk around. Of course, they have nice beach resorts too. Right? But the feeling of riding the, you know, the old carriages, it's so nice. It's a different feeling because now we're used to cars, right? Now when you ride a horse-driven calash or a carriage, it feels, well, you cannot say weird, but it's exciting, you know? Mm-hmm. And then shopping in their mall is even like an old trading post. So it's like you're shopping during the 16th century. It gives you a really different feeling. It's an entirely different experience, which, well, I might say I want everybody to experience too.
Uh-huh. So you won't go to the beach or like...
We still go to resort. The beach, but only on a weekend.
Okay.
But, you know, we always stay in town. Because mm-hmm. there's always... It's a Spanish town, so there's always like festivities everywhere. Nighttime, there's always like something new going on.
Really?
Yeah, because it's a tourist... Now it's a tourist destination, right? So what they did was like... They organize events. They have some things going on every day, especially on weekends.
For example, like during the night, what kind of like is it a festival or celebration?
No, during the night, you don't just eat inside the restaurant. They have the you know the chairs arranged outside, and then there's like somebody doing some entertainment. Yeah, it's a. We call it usually in the Philippines. We call it like a fiesta atmosphere.
Mm-hmm. It's a very it's like festive. A party.
Yeah, it's a very festive atmosphere.
Mm, yeah. Okay.
It's a good one. But then there are also, of course, on weekdays it's quiet, right? But you also appreciate the quietness because that's how it was during those times. So I couldn't really like describe it in words unless mm-hmm. you really go there because you will see the difference. You can mm-hmm. feel the difference.
Uh-huh. Yeah. 菲呢真係好掛住呢個地方，我知道，因為當佢呢懷念呢一個地方，或者我叫佢講解多啲呢個地方呢，佢講嘅時候個樣呢係好甜美嘅，同埋佢真係每次讲到呢个地方，佢嗰个笑容咧系真系呃唔到人嘅。咁我问到佢，其实呢个地方有啲乜嘢有啲乜嘢景点啊，好吸引。佢话其实每一个角落都好令到佢怀念呢一个嘅菲律宾，因为每一个角落都保存得好好。所以其实咧，佢通常去到 vegan 咧，都系尽量喺个 town 嗰度，个 town plaza 嗰度咧 spend 时间喺度行嘅。佢話好舒服嘅，你行一路每一個角落咧，都令到你諗起以前好十六世紀嘅時候嘅菲律賓係點樣？嗰個地方係好 Spanish， 即係好有西班牙嘅風味嘅。佢話你最緊要就係、是、即係對佢嚟講，去到呢一個 vegan 咧，對佢嚟講嘅重要性就係去到懷緬翻從前嘅一啲事。咁所以咧，佢每一路行。每個角落他都會想起當其時菲律賓人在這個西班牙統治下的一些足跡啊，一些點滴啊，還有他可以騎當時只可以貴族騎的馬車，他覺得整個感覺是非常之振奮的，很興奮，很開心，很特別的一個經歷。他說就算你去 shopping mall 都好，去到 shopping mall 呢，你都覺得佢好似你喺個十六世紀嘅年代咁樣去行緊街嘅，咁成件事咧，佢話佢盡量好努力咁樣形容俾我哋聽，但係你真係要去到嗰度咧，先至更加能夠感受到佢嗰個強烈嘅感覺，就係、是、好似翻翻去以前嘅時代嘅一種感覺。 咁佢就話由而呢個 vegan 咧，其實每一晚咧，因為佢而家係一個旅遊嘅熱點，咁每一晚咧幾乎weekend 尤其是每一晚都有啲節目啊，有啲活動咁嘅。咁例如佢好將啲凳啊啲，你唔係淨係喺個餐廳入邊食嘢嘅，佢啲餐廳會將啲凳咧擺曬喺出邊，咁咪會有人表演。咁所以咧，你就好係好似喺 patio 度，但係全部都係啲石仔路鋪嘅喎，真係好一個歐洲風味嘅一個感覺。你就喺個 patio 上面睇住人哋表演，咁佢哋成件事就好開心咯，好似開緊 party 咁，好盛大嘅一個活動咁樣，所以佢話好好玩嘅。咁當然呢個 figure 咧同任何一個菲律賓嘅地方一樣，都係有沙灘，亦都有好多個 resort 嘅。但係佢話佢通常都盡量係 spend 曬啲時間喺個灘度行，咁佢就已經覺得非常之滿足噶啦。Faye, thank you so much for telling us about this place.
Okay,
and I can tell from your face that you really miss this place. And I actually searched on the web and I have seen the pictures.
Mm-hmm.
I do agree with you that it looks so Spanish.
Yeah.
It looks like it's well kept too.
Yes, it's well kept. And well, I dream of doing some photo shoots in vegan someday.
Yeah. That would be great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It will show you how unique that place is.
Mm-hmm.
It's my one way of showing the world that vegan mm-hmm. is really like different.
But it's not close to Manila, right?
No. You take the plane.
We have to take the plane.
Yeah, you can either go by land, but it takes a while.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, better take it by plane.
Mm-hmm. 因為呢個地方咧唔近馬尼拉嘅，咁所以佢話佢真係好好鼓勵朋友去呢個地方度去欣賞下當其時西班牙嗰種嘅古蹟。咁但係就唔近馬尼拉，所以你馬尼拉係要搭飛機去嘅。咁但係若果真係去開菲律賓嘅話，去一去睇下啦。其實我都上網睇過啲相嘅，係真係好西班牙嘅風味嘅。咁撳啲相咧都睇得出佢係故意去保育呢一個地方，咁就成件事都真係好特別嘅。望啲相嘅話，咁若果真係去菲律賓嘅話，可以考慮去呢個地方。I know it's now a very popular tourism spot.
Yeah.
Is it expensive though? For example, to ride the carriage the hotel?
No. It's still a very simple town. I mean, expense-wise.
Expense-wise.
It's not, it's not very expensive.
How much is it to ride the carriage?
Oh, I don't know now, but probably takes you only a dollar or two. Well, maybe...
Canadian?
US.
US, okay.
It's cheap. Yeah, it's very affordable. That's why so many tourists, they go there. And some of the, you know, international movie productions, they always go there to shoot some scenes.
阿飛佢就話呢一個地方，因為而家係一個成為一個旅遊嘅熱點，咁我就 concern 會唔會而家貴咗咧啲嘢？佢話唔係，都係好平嘅。唔係一個貴嘅地方，同埋一個 small town 嚟嘅。咁坐馬車咧，佢話以前坐咧都係講緊可能$1到嘅啫，好划算嘅。咁佢話呢個地方特別到咧，而家可有好多拍攝電影嘅人咧，都特登去嗰個地方咧又取景啊。咁大家有興趣真係可以去下呢個 vegan 啦。And Faye, in vegan, is there like you have mentioned that you like eating the food in vegan. Is mm-hmm. there any like special food from the vegan that you like, well, that you miss?
In vegan, the town plaza, the specialty is like the Spanish empanada. It's like a bread, Spanish bread with mm-hmm. some stuffings on it. Maybe you can compare it to like Jamaican patties.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but it's different because it has some eggs there, it has some sausages there. Yeah. Okay. It's a very good one.
How do you call that?
Empanada.
Empanada.
Yeah, Spanish empanada.
Okay. 我問到呢個 vegan 咧，因為咁有呢個西班牙色彩嘅風味，嘢食方面有咩特別咧？佢話有一個食物叫做 Spanish empanada。咁呢個嘅呢個嘅美食係咩嚟嘅咧？其實就好似Jamaican 嗰啲嘅patty 嘅，咁係啲包嚟，其實西班牙嘅一隻 一種包，但係就好多 stuffing 喺入邊嘅。咁啊，佢話喺依一樣係喺 vegan 咧好出名嘅一個地道嘅美食嚟嘅。Thank you so much for telling us about this place and the food. We still have some time, so I would like to ask you any food that you like in from the Philippines that you like a lot.
Well, my favorite food is curry curry.
Curry curry. Is that curry or no? Curry curry. that name reminds me of curry.
it sounds like curry, right? But it's actually curry curry. It's a Filipino stew.
Okay. tell us more. Has to be beef then?
Mm-hmm. Curry curry. You know, Filipinos love to eat, right? Mm-hmm. But It's funny. They're still eating their main meal, but they're already thinking about their snack. Right? That's how they love to eat. But to me, of all these foods, I really love, as I said, kare kare. So there's no social gathering without this food.
Oh, okay.
It's very, very special. Mm-hmm. And it's actually a rich and meaty Filipino stew of oxtails, green beans,
mm-hmm.
green beans, eggplants, banana buds, and mixed with a sauce that is thickened with peanut butter.
Oh, okay.
It's so creamy and it's so delicious. You're hungry now?
yes. 我问到飞咧，咁因为仲有少时间，所以咧就想问一问佢，佢喺菲律宾度有啲乜嘢嘅食物佢系特别中意嘅？咁佢话有一样嘢食叫做 curry curry。咁我问佢系咪即系咖喱？佢话唔系，两件事嚟嘅。原来系一个其实系汤，但系其实根本系一个主菜嚟噶啦。佢系用牛尾去熬嘅一啲汤。咁好多好多肉嘅，咁所以咧话就话系汤，其实系餸嚟噶。咁佢就话每一个social 嘅 gathering 咧，真系不能够缺少呢个 curry curry 嘅。咁佢话咧系牛尾啦，仲有用啲eggplant 啦，即系呢个嘅矮瓜啦，有好多嘅唔同嘅豆类啦，仲有咧，因为好特别嘅sauce 咧，其实系用 peanut butter 做成嘅。咁佢话你一听咧，知道成件事咧，个汤系好浓、好浓味同埋好 creamy 嘅。But this is not a snack. This is the main course, right?
Yes, it's the main course. They always call it the Sunday food.
Sunday food. Oh, okay. is it hard to make?
Well, or just to be honest with you, I don't really cook, but
I like that.
But I really love to eat. But I don't think so, because I think you just boil the oxtail.
Probably just take time.
Yeah, it takes time because you want to make the oxtail really, really very soft, right?
Mm-hmm.
And after that, you mix it with those vegetables,
mm-hmm.
and that very, very rich and creamy peanut butter. But it's best when it's always accompanied by the sautéed shrimp paste.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The shrimp paste.
And of course with white rice. Yeah.
飞咧，佢就话佢就唔识煮嘢食嘅，其实佢就唔知点样煮呢一道菜。不过佢话应该唔会好难煮，应该就要多啲时间啦。不过因为始终你要熬一个好浓郁嘅汤嘛，咁佢就话呢一味餸咧非常之好咧，就系送饭啦。佢话咁今日非常之高兴咧，飞咧上到嚟同我哋咧倾咗咁耐偈，亦都特登咧上嚟咧介绍咧呢一个菲律宾嘅咁靓嘅地方叫 vegan， 咁我哋咧希望咧可以咧做阿飞咧有呢一个 fashion show 嘅时候咧，可能咧希望佢有时间再同我哋上嚟倾一倾偈啦。So say thank you so much for coming today.
You're welcome.
I hope
honored.
Thank you, and I hope that we will have another chance to talk after you have your fashion show or when you firm the date.
Of course.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much.
咁我而家休息一阵先，翻翻嚟咧，仲有第二个set文送俾大家嘅。欢迎翻翻嚟华语电台文化潮流菲律宾，又系我 Janet 带大家又玩又食嘅时候啦。 今个礼拜我哋请咗边位朋友上嚟同我哋倾菲律宾嘅旅行同埋美食咧？噔噔噔噔，就系上次上过嚟嗰位型男，大家记唔记得阿 Burbo 啊？佢上次咧就上过嚟同我哋讲佢喺菲律宾嘅一啲习俗啦，同埋点样庆祝呢一个嘅圣诞节嘅。咁今次佢再一次上到嚟啦，咁啊同我哋咧倾咩咧？今次咧佢就谂住同我哋介绍一个旅游嘅热点同埋呢个嘅美食啊。咁我哋事不宜迟啦，我哋快啲同阿 Burbo 倾下偈先。Good evening, everybody. Thank you for listening to the Canadian Chinese Radio. This is the cultural trends of the Philippines. Once you hear my voice like this, so hyper, it's always about food and tourism. This week, we have a gentleman here to help me to talk about the tourism in the Philippines.He actually came before. His name is Burbo, if you remember him from the dealership. He talked about the tradition and how the Filipino celebrate Christmas last time. Hi, Burbo.
Hey, Janet. Thank you for having me.
Hi. Thank you for coming. I know that you are here today to share with us a place.From the Philippines.
That's
and
correct.
Also one of your favorite food, I believe.
Yes.
Yeah, when we talked on the phone, he actually told me that he do have some ideas like what to cover for today's segment. So we can't wait. So let's start with tourism first, because all the audience love traveling, including myself.
We all do.
Which place that you are going to introduce to the audience?
The place is called Puerto Galera. It's one of the most popular beaches in the Philippines.
Oh, okay. It's a beach.
It's a beach. That's correct. It's about, if people are familiar with Manila, it's about 3 hours away from Manila. About 2 hour drive by car, and another hour boat ride. So it's
4 hours.
So it's a beautiful place.
Okay. 原來咧今日咧，Burbo 咧同我哋介紹嘅地方咧就叫做Puerto Galera。咁啊呢個地方咧，距離馬尼拉咧大概3个钟头嘅車程。咁原來咧搭完3个钟头嘅車咧，仲要搭多1个钟头嘅船咧，咁就可以嚟到呢一個地方啦。呢個地方有啲咩嘢咁出名咧？原來一個非常之出名嘅沙灘嚟嘅。Yes, I know there are so many beaches in the Philippines. What makes this one so special?
Well, what makes this one so special is that the proximity to the capital of Manila. So a lot of people can easily go to this place, because the other popular beaches that we have, like Boracay and Palawan, you need to go by plane to get there. And those two places are very expensive to stay, whereas Puerto Galera is more a convenient and budget friendly for a lot of people, but you still get the white beaches that a lot of people are looking for.
Okay, so it's actually distance wise, it's actually better.
Yes, in terms of distance, it's better, but in terms of people, especially tourists and foreigners looking for a great nightlife, they do have a lot of great places to spend the night as well. There's actually a section in Puerto Galera when if they just want to relax a little far from the nightlife, they do have that spot in the beach as well. So it's a combination of both. And again, as I said, the key attraction is the proximity from Manila to the beach.
Okay. Yeah, because it's actually closer.
That's correct.
原來咧，因為呢個我嘅沙灘咧，係比起其他啲沙灘，例如 Boracay 咁啦，距離馬尼拉係近啲啦。咁同埋咧，除咗個距離好啲之外咧，佢仲係又係集合咧呢一個relax 啊，即係沙灘就諗起 relax 啊，曬太陽咁啦。但係咧，佢嘅夜生活咧嘅 night life 咧都係非常之精彩嘅。咁所以咧，如果你又想兩樣都嘗試下少少咧，又唔想話去到距離呢一個馬尼拉太遠嘅話咧，呢一個地方咧確實係一個好好嘅選擇嚟嘅。So I guess a lot of tourists, whenever we think about beach, we just think about like sun, white sand. But just for the Filipino beaches, we always relate that to massage.
That's correct. That's one other good thing about the beaches in the Philippines.
Yeah.
Anywhere you go, especially the tourist areas, you can always have a massage right on the beach any time of day, and it's very inexpensive. That's the other thing.
It's actually for almost for every beach that there will be a massage.
Pretty much every beach that we're in tourists and foreigners go to, you can pretty much be assured that you can get a nice massage. That's correct.
Mm-hmm. Would you know about how much would that cost?
Well, you'd be surprised in terms of the price. 200 pesos would get you a good hour, beautiful massage. If you convert that into Canadian dollars, you'd be looking at $5.
Wow. Like for an hour?
For an hour, exactly.
An hour massage by the beach.
By the beach.
Five.
Exactly, for $5. You can't go wrong.
I can do that for a whole day. 咁啊，因為咧，我知道，因為同個好幾位嘉賓傾偈咧，就講開呢一個菲律賓嘅沙灘咧。每一個人諗起沙灘都會諗起好靚嘅陽光啦、太陽啦、好靚嘅沙啦，咁啊好靚嘅海洋啦。但係一講到菲律賓咧，除咗諗起呢啲元素之外咧，就會諗起 massage 啦。一有beach 咧，佢哋就會講：，唉，嗰度咧你可以喺個喺個好靚嘅沙灘，喺個海邊度。有人同你按摩，咁啊 ，Bubble 佢都话啦，真系你讲得冇错，其实几乎每一个沙滩你都可以有呢个享受嘅。咁啊，我就好想知价钱啦。咁佢就话价钱咧，你真系可以好 surprise， 有时平到咧，讲紧系200蚊 peso， 咁即系大概5蚊加币嘅啫。佢就会帮你按摩按一个钟嘅，5蚊一个钟按摩，仲要喺海边，我真系。全日都可以係 spend 我時間喺曬呢一個沙灘度都冇問題。Yes and beside like of course like beaches besides swimming sunbathing like any other activities particularly.
Of course, in this particular beach, you can do a lot of snorkeling and scuba diving. So there's a lot of good diving spots for people that enjoy the open water. So the beauty about the scuba diving and snorkeling at Puerto Galera is you don't have to go very far from the shore to get into the beautiful diving spots that they have as opposed to the other beaches in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm. So I guess scuba diving, there should be some classes?
Yes, so for new beginners, there'll be a shop in the beach where you can actually do a lesson before getting to the water. So they want to make sure that everything is safe for the person before they take you to the water.
Mm-hmm.
I've personally done the scuba diving when I went to Boracay 5 years ago with my wife.
Mm-hmm.
And the lesson took about an hour or so. To get us familiarized using the apparatus, the oxygen tube and the mask. So once it's done, they took us to the diving site, and and the beauty of scuba diving is you don't need to learn to know how to swim to scuba dive, because I can't personally swim, but I was able to scuba dive because you can breathe underwater. So it's a fantastic, fantastic experience.
That's actually good because I don't really know how to swim. Like, I know like the basics, but I basically can't swim by myself.
Thing with me, but with the scuba dive, you don't need to know how to swim because you can breathe underwater. So
uh-huh.
And you get to see the corals, the beautiful different color fishes. So it's a fantastic experience. I would recommend everyone to give it a try.
Mm-hmm. But it's like just 1 hour, then you are okay to go by yourself.
No, you don't go by yourself. There would be a certified scuba diver that would have to go with you during the dive. So unless you've done it for so many hours and you become certified, then that's the only time that you can go by yourself. But in the beginning, yeah. So there will be a guide going with you underwater,
mm-hmm.
taking you to places underwater.
So he will actually guide you and where, like you can
exactly.
see the moles,
exactly.
Marine animal, like marine lives.
That's
like basically, he will be the guide under
exactly.
the water.
Yeah, I thought I was actually swimming when I was underwater, but when I watched the video, because we actually had to get a video taken during the scuba dive, and then only in the video I saw that there's actually the other guy holding me on my back and then dragging me at the bottom of the ocean. So I thought I was swimming, but I wasn't. He was just dragging me. So it was pretty funny.
Is that expensive, scuba diving there?
It is expensive if you do it in North America, but in the Philippines, just like massage, 500 pesos, that costs about $10. And that gets you an hour of the scuba dive, and you add the cost of the equipment as well. So altogether, you can go for an hour of scuba dive for about 2,000 pesos, which is about $50.
Wow.
Includes the training, the equipment, and an hour underwater.
And the equipment?
Yes, so the equipment is included as well.
$15. $15 scuba diving, and then I spend $5 for massage. That's a pretty good deal.
That's a pretty good deal.
去到沙灘，另外一樣咧，去到菲律賓嘅沙灘咧，又係好 common 嘅，好出名嘅，就係咧潛水啦，咁啊 scuba diving。咁阿 Bubble 本身咧就係試過喺菲律賓嗰度咧，亦都試過scuba dive 嘅。咁我就同佢咁好傾咧，係因為咧我本人咧都唔太識得游水嘅，咁佢都係。咁佢就話唔識游水唔緊要，因為 scuba diving 咧，就算你唔識游水咧，佢 train 完你之後咧，你又可以喺水底度唞氣，咁所以咧唔識游水都可以玩嘅。咁佢就話咧，有個導師啦，會教你點樣用氧氣筒啊，即係佢所有嘅 equipment 啦。一個鐘頭嘅課程之後咧，你就可以咧跟住個導師咧落去水底度咧，咁啊睇下呢個海洋嘅生物嘅啦。咁啊導師咧原來係會帶住你玩一程嘅喎，一段路程。一段嘅路程，其实唔系一段路程，停玩好多程，除非咧到你玩咗好多次之后咧，你自己有 comfortable， 个导师嘅 comfortable 咧，你佢先会俾你自己过去玩嘅。咁好似阿 Bubble 咁啦，咁佢就当然佢就系全程都由个先生带住佢去玩啦。咁佢就话咧，成个过程好好玩，同埋非常之深刻啊，对佢嚟讲嘅印象。咁佢最紧要就系咩咧？咁啊，梗系要知道几多钱啦。咁啊，又系佢话好平嘅，讲紧。系200蚊 peso， 连埋晒个 training， 连埋晒 equipment， 200蚊 peso 即系大概咧15蚊加币到啫，即系咧，哇！去一去呢一个潜水15蚊，潜完水之后上嚟按个摩5蚊，20蚊喺呢一个嘅沙滩度全日嘅 activity 都已经系包好晒噶啦。Oh, Bubble, that sounds really, really good. Like the average amount that I have to spend in Philippines every day is probably like $30 Canadian.
Exactly. Including even less, food. Actually. That's one thing about the Philippines in terms of the cost of living is very, very low. So in order for you to enjoy life and have the luxury, you don't really have to spend a whole lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
So nowadays, there's a lot of foreigners, expats that actually do settle in the Philippines because of this amazing low of cost of living.
我就同阿 Bubble 讲，因为咁样计法，大概喺菲律宾度一日可能用嘅洗费都系大概30蚊咁上下嘅啫。佢话分分钟唔使添啊！咁亦都系因为咁样，菲律宾之所以出名就系、你可以享受佢好豪华嘅生活，但系亦都唔需要话花费太多。亦都系因为咁咧，就吸引咗好多外国人咧，有阵时嚟到菲律宾咧都唔想离开，直情系想喺嗰度定居。Yes, and Bubble. I know that this place is wonderful. Is there any special food? Not particularly from this place, but then if it's from this place, that's good. Or any food that you think is really good from the Philippines that you will recommend
There's
to the audience?
There's actually a lot of food that are good in the Philippines that your audience would enjoy. But one thing that I like in particular, personal favorite of mine is called the Filipino spaghetti.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little different from what we're used to here in Toronto, in the West. So it has that Filipino twist to it.
Filipino twist. Okay, yeah. Okay. So what is that?
what it is it has a little bit of sweetness to the spaghetti sauce. So we use it as a snack in the Philippines for the most part. But a lot of people use it as their main course. But in terms of how it is prepared, it is actually in the sauce that makes it really, really special.
Uh-huh.
So they add a little bit of sugar into the sauce. They put a slice of hot dog as well. It is a little difficult to make. There's a particular fast food in the Philippines. It's really, really popular, making the spaghetti, it's jalebi. It's pretty much the McDonald's of the Philippines, and this is their number one food in the restaurant.
Mm-hmm. So is it basically a spaghetti, but then you add some like sauce, which
it's exactly
sweet?
Like a spaghetti. It's just the sauce that's a little different. So with the sauce, they have the sweetness of the salt, as I said. So they add a little bit of sweetness to it. They use banana ketchup in terms of the ingredients as well. So they don't use just the regular tomato sauce. Okay, to add that additional flavor to the sauce, and the addition of sliced hot dog into the sauce really add that kick to the sauce. So it's something to try for sure.
When you mentioned banana ketchup,
yes,
I have never tried it. I've never tried this, and I've never known that it can be put in. In a spaghetti. So banana ketchup. How is that?
it's really, really good. It's a unique product of the Philippines. Once again, but what it is it has a little bit of sweetness to it, a little bit of spice to the ketchup as well, unlike the ketchup that we're used to here in Toronto. So that particular ketchup, with the addition of the sugar into the sauce and with the meat. So in terms of the preparation, it's exactly the same as how they prepare spaghetti here in the West, but with the addition of the use of the banana ketchup, the hot dog, and the amount of sugar that they put into the sauce, mm-hmm. that makes it really special.
So to conclude, the spaghetti, what is the how is it different from the Italian one? It's first of all the banana ketchup,
that's
hot
correct.
Dog,
that's correct,
and that you add the sweetness
to the sauce.
Okay, and how about vinegar? I know that the Filipino dishes, you all put vinegar.
We do in most of the dishes that we have, but on the preparation of the spaghetti, Filipino spaghetti, we don't use vinegar in this particular case.
Okay. Barbara 咁佢就介紹咗一個菲律賓嘅美食。咁佢就話佢自己好中意一個意粉啊，叫 Filipino spaghetti， 即係菲律賓式嘅意粉啦。咁同呢一個意大利嘅意粉有啲咩分別呢？原來佢話就原嗰個味道有少少唔同，佢就加咗啲甜味咧，就去到呢一個意粉嘅醬度嘅。同埋咧比較特別嘅咧，就係佢哋咧就用叫做 banana ketchup 香蕉味嘅茄汁咁樣啦。咁當然你知道呢個嘅香蕉都係帶甜嘅，咁所以咧個醬咧就更加係偏甜啦。咁佢就話咧個主要嘅 difference 咧就係佢加咗呢一個甜味去呢個醬。用这个 banana ketchup 已经是很特别，另外他就会用这个 hot dog 去摆埋落去呢一个嘅意粉度嘅，咁其实咧，如果你话净系睇个样啦，个样咧其实就系非常之同普通嘅意粉系非常之相似嘅，只不过系你一食落去嘅时候咧，你就知道咧佢同呢一个嘅普通嘅即系唔系普通意大利 style 嘅意粉咧系有唔同噶啦，就是、因为佢嘅甜味系重啲嘅。咁我就讲笑咁问佢，因为我知道咧菲律宾人咧整嘢食好中意落醋嘅，咁会唔会呢个意粉都落醋？佢就都笑，佢话系真系好中意落醋，不过呢个意粉咧就唔会落醋。咁啊，关于呢个 banana ketchup 咧，因为我就未试过嘅，咁所以咧，当佢讲到话呢一味餸咧系有 banana ketchup 嘅时候咧，咁我就当然要好奇会问一问咧，究竟 banana ketchup 系点样嚟啦？咁其实佢系菲律宾嘅一个特产啦，都系用呢一个嘅香蕉去做嘅茄汁啦，叫做咁其实咧。佢本身咧，我自己都做過少少嘅 research 嘅。其實佢本身做出嚟根本就唔係紅色嘅，有少少啡啡地咁嘅。咁通常咧，佢哋就將佢染色到染咗做紅色，咁所以先自己去做 banana ketchup。咁係一樣好真係好菲律賓、好地道啊、好地道嘅一個餸，因為佢用咗好多菲律賓嘅元素、嘢食嘅元素喺入邊啦，包括咧呢一個嘅 banana ketchup， 因為呢一個係菲律賓地道嘅呢個特產嚟嘅。Bubble, just wondering for the banana ketchup, How do you use that? Do you use that with fries? Do you use that with how we use the ketchup here?
It's funny because we actually use the brand of ketchup the way a regular ketchup is used here in Toronto. So you use it as a sauce. You can use it with your fries if you'd like. It's just pretty much a ketchup, but a little different flavor to it.
So you even in Canada, you also like prefer to use the banana ketchup.
Yes, my wife has a stack of banana ketchup in the house because she particularly loves the flavor of the ketchup. So instead of using a regular ketchup to dip our food, then you can use ketchup, a banana ketchup as mm-hmm. an alternative. And once your tongue is used to it, it actually tastes more flavorful.
Okay, but is it sweeter than the tomato?
It is sweeter than tomato. Yes.
Oh, okay, so yes. That's actually that's why you said the flavor is actually different and stronger.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Actually, when you told me that you are going to talk about the Filipino spaghetti, I also like searched about that,
uh-huh.
and I searched the banana ketchup, and that actually caught my attention. Well, one thing that I know that I really didn't know about this before, but then I just learned that. We have the banana ketchup is because tomato is actually in a huge shortage during the World War II, and that's why they use this. And I was like, oh, okay, like that's a really good story to share.
Yes, because we have an abundance of banana in the Philippines. That's absolutely right.
Yeah,
that's
to replace that. Okay,
exactly. Yeah, and it turned out to be good.
And I was going to say it turns out to be good, and it turns out to be one of the special products
exactly,
from the Philippines.
Exactly.
咁我同阿 Bubble 講，因為 banana ketchup 呢樣嘢真係比較特別啦。相信我哋糖我自己真係未試過。咁但係你會知道，譬如你用普通嘅茄汁嘅話咧，咁應該真係唔會比起呢一個 banana ketchup 咁甜嘅。咁我就問佢，其實佢會用嚟即係會唔會好似當茄汁咁用啊？譬如點啊薯條咁樣，佢話其實佢真係會嘅。其實佢同佢太太都係 prefer banana ketchup 嘅。咁呢一個嘅ketchup 咧，佢自己因為好 prefer， 所以佢盡量佢比較用多用呢一個多過用普通嘅茄汁。咁因為味道咧係真係濃啲啦，同埋甜少少嘅。相似不過真係濃好多。咁因為其實佢當初我同佢聯絡嘅時候，佢同我講話會講呢一個嘅 Filipino spaghetti 嘅時候咧，我都上網 search 過關於呢一個嘅。呢一個美食嘅，咁我都睇到呢一個 banana ketchup， 咁我就覺得好特別，咁所以我都 search 過下，咁原來咧點解會有 banana ketchup 呢個 idea 出現呢？原來咧當其時咧第二次世界大戰咧喺呢個菲律賓咧就缺乏呢一個嘅tomato 啊，即係呢個番茄，咁於是乎咧佢哋就諗到，因為佢哋有好多香蕉，咁所以咧就諗到用蕉做呢一個嘅ketchup 咧去到 replace 咗呢一個，即係代替咗。这个的用番茄做的茄汁的，也是一个我觉得都是一个值得跟大家分享的一个典故。我们现在休息一阵先，回到我们还有第二个环节送给大家的。 Thank you for sharing this beautiful place and also the Filipino spaghetti with the audience. Thank you,
Burbo.
And I hope that we can talk again whenever we have some other ideas.
I hope so too.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
Let's take a break, and after that, we will have more segment for you. 欢迎收听华语电台 CCL 文化潮流菲律宾，我是 Janet 啊。今日咧，我哋呢一个嘅录音室咧，非常之热闹。热闹嘅并唔系因为多人，而系真系好多笑声。今日我哋请到一位朋友咧，佢系喺菲律宾嘅一份报纸度写，佢有一个专栏嘅。咁啊，净系同佢倾电话嘅时候，已经觉得非常之高兴，非常之有趣嘅一位朋友。一嚟到咧入门口讲咗三句咧，我啊邦同埋呢一位朋友咧已经笑到真系哈哈声啦。咁啊，相信今日嘅录音室咧就会非常非常之开心，非常之热闹。无论如何，我哋首先欢迎佢。佢个名字就叫做 Aris Espinosa Ting。Today we are very happy because I have a guest. Once she step into the studio, The only thing we can hear is the laughter. She is very cheerful, very friendly. Even before I met her, I knew it's going to be an interesting interview because she is a good writer. let me introduce Ariz Espinosa Ting. Hi, Ariz.
Hi, how are you, Janet?
Good, thank you. Thank you so much for coming.
You're welcome.
I am so happy. Even before I met you on the phone, I have already known how interesting this interview will be.
Well, probably I should have been a comedian, you know?
By the way, today we beside me and this lovely guest, we also have Bon here. Hi, Bon.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening. This is Bong Faldas, Culture Trend of Philippines.
Wow, the sound of that voice is the sound of power, and I love that kind of voice.
And I love this enthusiastic voice. Same as you, Oris. Yeah, same as you. But well, you know what? Before our interesting interview, let me have our lovely guest to introduce yourself first.
Okay, my name is Oris Ting. I am now a retired public servant, having worked for over 30 years with the Ministry of the Environment. But I came to Canada in the late 60s, 69 to be exact, and in Edmonton for 5 years, and the next many years here in Toronto. And right now, what can I say about retirees? They are looking more active, more pretty. I hope I am.
Definitely. Ask Bon. Look at him. His face goes red.
And I come from the province of Tarlac, Philippines, where our president, President Ninoy Aquino, is from. You know, the Corazon Aquino, the mother, and the present President Ninoy Aquino. And I'm proud to say I still speak the language, Kapampangan, but it is a mixture of Tagalog, Pangasinan, Kapampangan, and of course, majority of Filipinos, they can speak English.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so French. No.
That's why I say it's going to be a funny interview. French? No. Same as me. French? No.
No. No. We?
Tagalog? No. But I'm hosting a Filipino show.
You know, I'm very pleased that you're doing this. And
I think
it is really time that Filipinos will be exposed in terms of the relationship between Filipinos and Chinese. And the Chinese has been with us in our country even before the Spaniards came. It's unfortunate they did not really put forward their culture in terms of language or whatever compared to the Spaniards. But right now, it's a mixture of everything. You know, Americans, Japanese, Koreans, they're all over us, you know. I think because Philippines is known for his, especially the people, is known for their hospitality, kindness, pretty women. In fact, I heard one...
Pretty women.
No, I'm really proud to say there was one European man when I was traveling where he was interviewing and says, "Can you, sir, tell us which one is all over the world, which one is the prettiest woman?" And you know, he mentioned Filipinos.
Mm-hmm.
And suddenly I felt so good. Maganda pala ako. I'm pretty.
I gotta learn that. Okay, 同大家翻譯一下先啦。 Orisla 佢介紹一下自己啦。咁佢係而家咧現時已經係一位退休嘅人士。咁佢之前咧其實係幫政府做嘢嘅。佢係 Ministry of Environment嗰度做嘢，咁做咗好多年噶啦。咁佢移民咗嚟加拿大咧都非常多年，佢移民咗喺度三十年噶啦。咁啊，佢話佢由1969年已經移民到嚟加拿大噶啦，一段好長嘅時間。佢曾經喺愛文頓度住過5年。咁而家佢作為一個退休人士，佢就話 佢喺眼中，佢而家覺得退休人士咧係需要啲咩？就係而家比以前更加有活力，同埋更加靚。我好中意佢呢個咁嘅自信嘅講法。佢真係一個保養得非常之好嘅一位女士嚟嘅。咁佢話：我哋而家最緊要就係即係多啲活躍，比以前嘅退休人士活躍好多啦，靚好多啦。咁其實我覺得愛美咧係對自己一種尊重嚟嘅。咁錫自己先至會咁貪靚噶嘛。咁阿 Oris 咧，佢嚟自咧菲律賓一個叫做塔力嘅一個地方。咁呢一個地方咧，其實咧總統都係喺嗰度住噶啦。咁所以佢係非常之為自己而驕傲嘅，喺呢嗰度居住，兼且仲仍然識得講嗰度嘅地方嘅語言。咁佢就話啦，佢非常之高興咧，可以嚟到我哋呢一個嘅菲律賓嘅節目度做嘉賓，因為佢覺得咧中國人咧喺佢哋嘅家鄉咧已經係有好多好多年嘅歷史。咁对他们来讲，中国人和菲律宾有一种很特别的情意结，所以他自己就很喜欢的。另外就是他不得不强调他自己很喜欢菲律宾，所以他对菲律宾很多很多东西都很有赞美 的 message 的。例如他觉得菲律宾人是非常之好客，非常之热情，而他 mention 了一个我自己本人就是觉得非常之好笑，而且都是因为这样我觉得非常之觉得他自己真的很 proud of 做一个菲律宾人，同埋一位非常之有趣嘅女士，因为佢就话菲律宾最多咩就系靓女啦。咁我都话Oris 将会系带给我哋一个非常之有趣嘅interview， 因为净系个 introduction 都咁精彩啦。Oris， I was actually telling the audience just your introduction is already so entertaining. The pretty woman part, I like it a lot.
You do it. That's really good. But that's what really I've read and I've heard. And I don't know, Bong, what do you think?
We have Miss Philippines Universe in 1969 with Gloria Diaz. We have Miss Universe.
Gloria Diaz, I believe, is Miss Universe, isn't it? Miss International is Gemma Cruz.
Gemma Cruz Araneta. We have a lot of beauties in the Philippines. It's yours to discover, radio listeners.
阿邦都最加句，佢话我哋菲律宾嘅女人真系好靓嘅。佢都话咧，1969年咧，个菲律宾小姐咧已经成为咗呢一个呢个嘅全球最靓嘅女士，即系 Miss Universe 嘅一个比赛冠军。咁所以咧，佢话你哋慢慢去发掘啦，我哋菲律宾嘅女士真系非常之靓嘅。Okay, let's focus on Oris because you are our guest today. When I know that you write in the newspaper, I am so excited because I personally love writing and I love reading. Why don't you tell the audience what do you write right now? I know the topics is actually interesting.
You know, what can I say? I only started being active, doing some writing. I'm not really a writer. I just enjoy whatever comes to my head, I just write it down, and I love creating poetry because it comes from the heart. And you don't even have to think. It just comes out. And for me, my column, which is in Balita, I love writing about seniors. For me, being a senior now, how we have reached the stage of not really downhill, but rather being strong, being part of everyone, competing with the strength of the youth. And for me, I make it in such a way to, oh, okay, it's not bad after all. You know, the memory lapse, hurting knees here and there, and taking care of this and that. Thank God I can say my mind is still clear. I can still write a little bit. I normally just do it on the deadline. If today is the deadline, I do it in the morning to write it down. I wish I should give more time. But I think that way, you know. So because I'm not a writer, I just enjoy writing.
Mm-hmm. But I love your topics. let me translate this to the audience first, then we will talk about, for example, what kind of funny topic that you have written already. Orissa 佢寫嘅文章咧係喺菲律賓嘅一個份非常之出名嘅報章度啦，叫 Bolita 啦。咁佢嗰度咧就有佢自己嘅專欄嘅。咁佢話其實佢自己並唔係一個作家，但係佢自己本身咧係好中意寫作。咁佢亦都好中意寫啲詩，亦都好中意閱讀詩啊。因為佢覺得咧詩詞咧係從心出發嘅，由心嚟到出發嘅，亦都唔需要咧思考咁多，亦都唔需要諗咁多。總之咧，你諗到啲咩嘢寫出嚟咧，咁呢個咧就係佢最覺得最最美麗嘅地方啦。咁佢其實喺 Bolita 呢份報紙度寫咩咧？其實佢寫關於長者嘅嘢嘅。長者嘅事佢咧就但係佢就唔係話寫唔係話點樣描述啲長者啊，點樣生活啊，而係佢係覺得佢而家點樣可以達到而家呢個 stage 咁有好多其他譬如一啲有趣嘅事啊，又或者長者對呢一個嘅生活啊，點樣 take care 自己啊，等等等等嘅嘢咧，佢自己咧都非常之有興趣去寫嘅。咁純粹係一啲好娛樂性嘅一啲嘅題材。咁佢都話，因為佢自己中意寫作啫嘛，又唔係真係個作家。咁佢都話啦，好多時咧都係有個 deadline 咧，佢就會寫。咁總之，譬如deadline 係今日，佢咪一朝早就寫，諗到啲咩就寫咩。其實呢個先至係一位好的寫作人的一個寫作的 style 來的。因為如果你思考太多呢，反而呢就不是真的由你的心出發，越是在身邊的事物有些什麼寫，有些什麼見到就寫下來呢，這一種呢才是你對這個生活有觸覺的一個表現。So I was I agree with you so much about you don't need to think so much. It just comes out. If you pay attention to anything, even if it's so like minor, even if it's just a small thing, you can actually write about it. I actually agree with that. And I know that just like you said you just write about senior. And you just want to write something funny. Can you give us some example?
Gosh, it will be kind of difficult for me right now. But I remember what my dad, growing up, my dad was telling us, if you can write, you can go anywhere. Mm. If you can write. You know, he's talking to me in grade school. It's bad enough that you want to play outside. And my dad said, you don't have to really have good grades, but I want you to make sure that anything that you would like to express, put it in writing. So I remember that. So in high school, I started, you know, we were busy trying to be attractive with boys in high school, you know what I mean? So, our editor is always telling us, because I studied high school and university in the central part of the Philippines, we call Visayas, and I think Bong knows this, it's called Siliman University, and most of those people there speak the dialect Bisaya, Cebuano, and coming from Manila, I do not speak the dialect, so you tend to speak in English. And they keep telling me, Oras, why didn't you write something in Tagalog? Mm-hmm. I said, are you kidding? Excuse me, I don't want to waste my time. But I did anyway, just to keep myself busy and to shut my editor. And from then on, I married a Chinese born from Cebu. He's a medical doctor, may he rest in peace. He loves poetry. And I fell in love so much, not with him, but because of the poetry. And we clip the rest is history, and may he rest in peace.
So let's tell the audience your brief story about how you are into poetry. Orissa 佢話其實佢 由以前喺呢一個嘅菲律賓咧，已經咧寫作噶啦。咁但係佢點解會寫作？係因為佢嘅父親咧去到鼓勵佢，佢話：若果你能夠寫作嘅話咧，你就去到邊度都得噶啦。總之你諗到啲乜嘢咧，我都希望你可以將你諗到嘅嘢咧寫落嚟。咁佢以前其實係喺Versailles， 即係維爾薩斯嗰個地方住嘅。咁佢曾經咧俾呢個編輯咧就同佢講：不如你試下寫。用菲律賓的語言，即係佢哋一個好common 嘅語言 Tagalog， 咁你就不如咧寫啲嘢啦。咁佢開頭都唔係話咁願意嘅，但係之後佢就嘗試咗啦。而另外佢就話咧，佢因為之後咧就遇到佢丈夫啦。咁佢丈夫而家就已經唔喺度噶啦。但係當其時佢遇到佢丈夫嘅時候咧，佢丈夫咧係讀呢一個嘅medicine 嘅，但係佢話佢咧好熱愛呢一個嘅詩詞歌賦，咁所以咧佢就因為咁而愛上咗。
That's why love can change a woman a lot.
Thank you.
I don't know if Bon agrees.
he has to agree.
I agree with that.
Yeah, usually man has no say when there are more than one woman in the room, especially.
I know. Filipino, especially Filipino men, they tend to be not submissive to their wives, but just to avoid any long arguments, they tend to keep quiet. But they still rule the family. You know what I mean?
Oh, that can be an interesting topic. It's like a Filipino man versus Chinese man. Because when you say the Filipino men, they want to avoid like any conversation to that might potentially cause any arguments. That's actually, I think that's quite common in Chinese, in our culture, actually. But I'm talking about not my generation. Like, I mean, when I see my parents or my, like, auntie, uncles, they are, like I do observe that too. Yeah, they would just have worry, like, no, oh, it's okay.
Yeah, that's right. But, and yet, you know, in terms of even salary-wise, they both work at the end of the month. The husband gives the money to the wife, and the wife takes care of everything.
Mm-hmm.
But it's still the man who rules, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But management-wise, children raising, I believe the father, the man, is busy trying to make a living, and the mother is trying to raise kids. This is how I feel. I don't know what is the generation now. Having no children of my own, I noticed with my brothers and sisters. My brother seems to be quiet, and the wife is always the one making the decision in terms of what to eat, where to go, and here and that. And I think it's very good. And whether the Chinese are doing the same thing,
mm-hmm.
Well, we're all Asians, my dear.
Maybe, or maybe actually all guys are like this.
I like that. I like that. Probably all guys are like that. Right, Bong?
I agree.
See, did you hear that? I agree.
Bon, it's like he represents
the whole Filipino community. I agree.
Oh,
so
no.
No trouble right there.
You know, basically, after a guy said "I do," for the rest of his life, he can only say "I agree."
I agree, and I do.
好好笑啊！我哋咧因為我哋延伸咗另外一個 topic 啦，咁我哋就同阿 Aris 講開啦。我就話啊，因為佢先生咧就好中意呢一個嘅詩詞歌賦啊文學咁嘅，咁我就話啊，原來一個即係愛情其實真係好改變到個女人嘅，一個男人如果佢係咁有影響力嘅話咧，而個女士又咁中意佢嘅話咧，好多時個男人喜歡啲咩咧，我哋女士可能好自然就會中意咗呢樣嘢噶啦，咁。我就同阿 Aris 讲开呢件事，咁佢就话其实讲开呢个菲律宾嘅男人咧，佢哋通常都非常之非常之识做嘅，佢哋会讲乜嘢都好啦，佢哋尽量都会 avoid 任何嘅拗撬嘅。咁譬如有啲乜嘢嘅 conversation， 有啲乜嘢讲讲下觉得唔对路啦，佢哋就决定就诶得啦，转啦 ，OK 噶啦 ，OK 噶啦，我哋唔会因为咁样而有任何嘅拗撬嘅。咁佢就話其實呢，我就話咁其實呢個都係一個好得意嘅題材，因為我哋其實中國人嘅社會呢都會係咁嘅，好多男士呢都好有風度啦，當然係咁佢哋take care 成個 family 嘅，佢哋搵錢呀、所有嘢，就算
即係點都好啦，佢哋會好 take care 成個屋企。而去到啲小事或者啲咩拗撬嗰啲咩事就得㗎啦 ，OK 㗎啦 ，OK 㗎啦咁。咁啊 ，Oris 就話佢就真係notice 到呢一樣嘢啦。咁通常啲先生咧其實就真係冇乜所謂嘅，好多時都其實我哋又唔會話佢哋驚我哋嘅，但係佢哋冇乜所謂咁啦。咁譬如大家都有做嘢，大家都有糧出嘅話咧，先個丈夫咧就會俾曬啲錢俾個老婆，個老婆咧就會 take care 其他嘢啦。咁但係個丈夫其实都是管理整个家的，即譬如他怎样去到赚钱啊，怎样去到照顾整头家，但是到细节位所有东西都是得㗎啦 ,OK 㗎啦，老婆你话咩时候咩啦咁。咁我哋就讲笑咁问阿邦同唔同意啊，阿邦就话佢好同意，非常之同意。咁我哋即刻讲笑啦。咁其实一个男人呢，自从讲完我愿意之后呢，基本上所有以后所有嘅问题问佢，只可以讲我同意㗎啫。So Bong, you having a good time there? He can only say yes and I agree for the whole recording.
I am so impressed, Janet, the way you translated in Chinese. I wish we have that ability to do it in Tagalog.
Oh, thank you.
And I challenge Bong here. Just kidding.
He won't say anything other than yes and I agree for the whole recording. That's what he's going to say.
All I can say, sit, Bong.
No, you know what? We probably want some high tea after the recording, Bong.
What can I say? Yes, definitely. You know,
我哋呢度真系非常之高兴，因为我哋开始阿邦咧，自从俾我哋即系Oris 咁聪明咁将呢个题材讲到男女同埋讲个男人。菲律賓的男人怎樣對他們的太太，怎樣對他們的家，全部都是非常之非常之順服，但是也都有他男士的風範的。就是因為這樣，阿邦在我們今天的錄音室裡面真的只是可以說 yes 和I agree， 就是我同意這樣。You know what, Aris, we've been talking for so long and it's time to say goodbye.
Oh!
But we don't want to end this like this. Your interview, it has to be longer. So let's continue Oris interview next week. Next Monday, we will be here again and we will have Oris again to talk more about Filipino culture.
Oh, okay.
Thank you for listening to our show. We will see you next week. Good night.开心的时间是过得很快的，尤其是当你和一个非常之好谈的朋友在这里谈话，时间过得更加快。有时候呢，我们要说拜拜了。不过呢， Oris 咁风趣，他的 interview 怎可以咁短啊？我们下个礼拜同样时间会送上 Oris 第二部分的 interview 的，咁大家记住继续支持我的 show 啦。记住逢星期一夜晚10点至12点，有我 Janet 带你们继续认识菲律宾更加多的文化、更加多的食物和更加多的地方。拜拜方，拜拜方，拜拜方，拜拜方，拜拜方，拜拜方，拜拜方，拜拜方，拜拜方，拜拜方。